Where did you get this hair? What's the name of this hairstyle?
Why is your hair like this? It's so bushy.
Wow, how did you do that hair?
Is that your real hair?
Yes.
Some black women deal with comments like these about their hair every day. These pressures start from a young age. Annie Juggernaut is 13 and so uncomfortable with her Afro hair, she doesn't want to be seen by her friends.
When I have to go to school, I try my very best to cover it up, maybe with like my jacket, or try and hide anyone seeing me with my curly hair, because I just feel like it's not very nice to have curly hair. For me, not everyone, but for me mainly.
She is chemically straightening her curls today. She's been doing this since she was just 4 years old.
As I grew up, I feel like straight hair suits me more and it makes me feel like I'm like everyone else. I basically mean like my friends. If we all have straight hair, we're all equal, we're all friends, we're all like each other. And I'm not one to be different as well. So I would love to have straight hair. And like when everyone else has straight hair, for like, if I have straight hair, I feel pretty with it. And I do feel pretty with straight hair.
How are you feeling?
Myself again, maybe, because I love having my hair like this.
The hair shops along this street are filled with black women of all ages, and their children are coming to get their hair relaxed from as young as 9 years old. And for some, the pressures continue into their adult life.
A mum from Essex is on a mission with a new campaign to get Annie and other young women to change their mind after realising Afro hair is rarely seen in beauty advertising.
To put Afro textured hair on billboards all around London and hopefully all around the UK, so that not just black women and girls can see, but also white women, Asian, Latinos can also see Afro hair as normal. A lot of women have come to me where their children are asking for their hair to be straightened. And I don't think that's a good premise for a girl, especially in this society where women are made to think so much about how they look as against what they can do.
A quick search online shows why. Search unprofessional hairstyles and almost all of the results show black women with Afro hair. Simone Powdley from South London was turned down for a job because of her braids. She was told they were unprofessional for selling high-end products.
I feel the less diversity that you have, the more that you feel self-conscious and self-aware.
Chuma Soko teaches Londoners how to style their Afro hair for work. She thinks the stigma will only go when diversity improves.
The future is looking bright in terms of encouraging our young women to actually be able to accept themselves as they are. And I think it's just going to be amazing what we will see. And there definitely will be a huge change in terms of the workplace especially.
The pressure to have straight hair starts at a young age, and it's there, campaigners say, that change needs to start too. Tanyaradzwa Nyenwa, ITV News.